Okay, next up we have Karen Goldstein. Karen, tell us a little bit about what it is that you do.
Hi. I am actually not currently working in television production, but it's what brought me out to San Diego.
So you work in television production. Okay, now I'm going to ask you a question, all right? What part of your academic preparation at Emerson College, where you went to college in Boston, provided you the best opportunities for television production?
I was fortunate enough to go to Emerson College. It's a communication school in Boston. It's all, any aspect of communication, television, film, radio, communication disorders, theater, and all the teachers that are there are all in the business. So they, when they teach about, not just about opening up your creativity and following your passion and supporting you and all of that, but they also give you the real, you know, okay, this is what it's like in the real world. Right now, you're making your own films and you're producing things and you're, you know, king of the mountain, but when you get out of here, you're going to be fetching people coffee. So it was it was a very grounded way of being taught, and they also really encouraged internships, which I really strongly suggest. If you have anything that you're interested in, any facet of whether it's, you know, of the media, find a company that is that has that, and see if you can get internships, especially while you're young, living at home, and you don't have to worry about paying your mortgage or rent or whatever. Work for free. See if you like it. It's a good way of getting your feet wet. People watch you. The people of the companies watch you while you're at these internships, and you make connections that can help you in numerous ways down the road.
Okay, who are the TV production people, kind of behind the scenes? Any kind of technical arts people out there? Okay, we got a few over here. Who wants an internship with MTV? I do. Is Laura Grier here? See, they got the alphabetical. There it is. All right. Now, Laura, you are the owner and lead photographer of Beautiful Day Photography. Is that right? Okay. If you could do anything differently with regards to your profession, what would it be?
Nothing, actually. I actually love the path that I've taken, and I kind of took the approach that I figured out what I really enjoy in life at a young age, around 15 or 16. And it was, I knew that I loved photography, and I knew that I loved traveling and adventures, and I knew that I get bored easily, and I didn't want to sit at a desk for like 9 to 5 every day, and I kind of just thought about different careers that could have that fit my lifestyle. And so I decided to go to school in New York for photography. And what was cool about it was that once you learn a trade and you get that experience, then it opens up so many doors, because it's not just a very limiting field. Anybody and everybody needs photography, whether it's for websites or for advertisements or medical photography or forensic photography. And I just knew that it opened up a million doors for me. So had I known at art school I'd be a wedding photographer, I don't think I would have known at that point. But my path brought me to Los Angeles because it was freezing in New York. And then I was, again, reality check where I was broke and I needed money and I didn't even own a camera. And so I did everything. I worked jobs. I begged my way into working at a photo studio, and I went on Wheel of Fortune and won $7,000 and bought my first camera. Just random things happening, whatever way I could earn money. But after that, I just really hustled, and I worked for photo studios, and it's brought me to today, where I own a destination wedding photography business. I do international weddings and travel all over the world. I just got back from Africa for a month, shooting and traveling, and I get paid for it, and it's amazing. And I have my own editorial section in a magazine that I get to write about my travels and my photos. I won a National Geographic Traveler contest recently for one of my photos, and it just opened up all these doors and opportunities where, you know, I now get to do exactly what I love to do every day. And even now today, I'm still tailoring my career to do the things that I love, and I'm going to start teaching travel photography workshops. And you know, I don't sit idle and just hope that jobs come to me. And I think that I've been that way since I was 15. And I think I don't think I would do anything differently. I love where I'm at.
All right. I'm photographers are out there? Anyone? Oh, we got quite a few photographers. All right, very cool. How many people want to go to Africa? All right, very cool. Well, you guys can both talk.